You might remember Dr. Joe DeTore from when he joined us back in April. This is him discussing his mission to live underwater for 100 days.
And the honest reason why I'm staying 100 days is because I can't stay 200 days.
My preliminary results indicate that I had a decrease in cholesterol and my coherence appears to be up. In other words, I appear to be more focused on task.
Sometimes the missing aren't gone forever. They're just waiting to return when the world least expects it.
You solved one of the longest missing child cases in the history.
Today we have stories of those who were gone, yet out of nowhere, they reappeared, leaving behind only whispers and questions.
Is it him?
A little bit older, but yeah.
My sweetheart's wife. Oh my God.
What really happened during those lost years? Let's find that out.
Julian Hernandez discovered he'd been missing for 13 years, kidnapped from Alabama by his father, Bobby.
It's a selfie taken by a hiker of his legs dangling over a cliff in a scenic area of California. Well, it turns out that photo helped save his life.
In April 2021, hiker Rene Compian found himself in trouble in the San Gabriel Mountains. He sent a desperate text to a friend saying he was lost and his phone was about to die.
Panicked hiker texted the photo to his roommate, stating he was lost and that his cell phone was dying. Right after he hit send, his phone died.
After a day of searching with no success, the sheriff's department turned to social media for help. That's when a local guy saw Renee's photo on Facebook. Trusting his instincts and local knowledge, he tipped off the rescuers about a specific area where Renee might be hiding. Authorities quickly dispatched a helicopter, and thanks to that local hero, Renee was found safe and sound.
They popped out of the clouds and he was right there. And it was within 3/4 mile of where I'd marked the GPS location.
Sometimes it takes just one person to turn a desperate situation into a joyful reunion.
Renee only had a small bottle of water and 2 breakfast bars on him. And he says next time he goes hiking, he's going to pack a lot more.
147 days.
2 American women and their dogs are safe after a frightening ordeal at sea. The U.S. Navy came to their rescue.
2 friends named Jennifer Appel and Tasha Fuyaba from America set out from Hawaii to Tahiti with their dogs, Zeus and Valentine, for what was supposed to be an epic journey. But soon after they departed, disaster struck. The rigging broke, a storm knocked out their motor, and their communication went silent. Stranded in the vast Pacific for 147 days, they sent distress signals daily, but no one heard them.
It was very depressing, and it was very hopeless, but the only thing you can do, so you do what you can with what you have. You have no other choice.
Until a Taiwanese fishing boat finally found them 900 miles off course.
We had less than 24 hours before our boat sank.
Just days later, the USS Ashland swooped in for a rescue.
It was incredibly emotional, and it was so satisfying to know the men and women that serve our country would come and assist us.
With water purifiers and a year's worth of dry food, they survived the ordeal. But now they're thinking twice about setting sail again.
You're alive, you're fed, you have water, your boys are happy, and there's love.
Faint call.
A chance encounter and a stroke of luck. That equation helped save a hiker who had been stranded in Rockland County.
Just a whisper of hope can make all the difference. That's exactly what happened when 46-year-old Mandeep Diwani found himself stranded in Rockland County after a hike gone wrong. He set out for a trek at Nyack Beach State Park, but failed to return home, prompting his worried wife to report him missing.
It's very steep, rocky terrain. It's very slippery due to the leaves.
With temperatures dropping into the 30s overnight, the search began. Just when it seemed like time was running out, a jogger named Atleast Vandorp heard his faint cries for help.
To try to, scream up the mountain, they started communicating with me.
She quickly alerted another runner, and they called 911.
About 1/4 mile down, and I heard somebody screaming, like, help.
Rescue crews, equipped with drones and helicopters, worked tirelessly to find him. Thankfully, Mandeep was located and returned back with his family.
They located him. I knew they had helicopters. They got the drones right away. Paramedics were here quickly.
Lost. Found.
5 years goes by, and You and your family, you don't hear a peep, right? Did you give up hope? Did you think she was still out there somewhere?
You never give up hope. I never stopped looking for...
In 2013, 14-year-old Emily Paul disappeared from Tallahassee, Florida, leaving her family heartbroken and searching for 5 long years. Her cousin, Lissa Parker, never gave up hope, always scanning the crowds for a familiar face. Then, out of the blue, Emily's mother received a letter.
In the letter, she basically said, yeah, I'm okay, I'm 19, I'm safe, I'm happy, I'm healthy, and I'm where I want to be.
Now 19, Emily assured her family that she was safe, happy, and exactly where she wanted to be. To confirm it wasn't a hoax, police urged Emily to come forward.
Emily, if you'll do this, then I can just close this case and I can have a peace of mind knowing you're okay.
Miraculously, she did, walking into a local station to speak with a detective. Although she chose to keep her location secret, her family remains hopeful she'll return one day.
She's an adult now, and she gets to make that decision. I'm just hoping one day that she'll want to come back into all of our lives.
Final recording.
So that's it.
The sun's going down.
That's a wrap on old Mickey.
In 2016, Jacob Childs found himself alone, treading water 30 miles off the coast of Australia after being separated from his dive group, with the dive boat disappearing and the sun setting. He recorded what he thought might be his final moments using a GoPro, thinking the end was near. But Jacob wasn't completely out of luck. His bright orange emergency flotation device kept him afloat for 6 long hours. Just when hope was fading, a search plane spotted him and brought him to safety.
Plane's coming back. Hold it. Plane enough to come back.
Jacob believed his wetsuit kept him from freezing, but the reality is his calm mindset kept him alive. Sometimes it's about staying cool when the waters get rough.
I was scared. I was thirsty.
That's a wrap on old Mickey, I guess.
Lost for months. When life throws you overboard, sometimes all you can do is hope for the best. Lewis Jordan knows this all too well after surviving 66 days lost at sea.
The boat had turned around, and I was flying through the air, somersaulting.
His boat capsized during a storm, leaving him injured and adrift. With his collarbone broken and no way to sail, he relied on catching fish with seaweed and collecting rainwater to survive.
So thirsty, and I was almost out of water. And every day I was like, please God, send me some rain, send me some water.
Through sheer determination and faith, he fought against hunger, thirst, and a boat that flipped 2 more times. His miracle came when a container ship spotted him 200 miles off the coast. They saved him from that, and against all odds, he made it back, proving miracles do happen.
What was it like when you got that call from your son?
It was a real shock because I had begun to decide after more than 2 months that he may never come home.
Autistic boy.
Is it him?
A little bit older, but yeah.
My sweetheart's wife. Oh my God.
In 2022, Utah deputies made a jaw-dropping discovery when they found Connor Jack Oswalt, a teenager missing for nearly 3 years. Police officers spotted him sitting outside a gas station.
Want to come sit in his car and warm up for a minute?
He was cold and down on his luck, but came to warmth in the sheriff's car.
They took his fingerprints in the car and then did some more digging. They realized something extraordinary. He seemed to be a match for a teenager who'd been reported missing nearly 3 years ago.
They did his fingerprint scan and found out he was the boy reported missing in 2019. Connor, who has autism, vanished from California, leaving his family heartbroken. When his mom heard the news, it felt like a dream come true.
It's my baby, you know? I never stopped looking. You don't know how many times I've dreamed of that call, or just opening the door and he was there.
Silent Woods.
A hermit who was presumed dead after disappearing 20 years ago has been found alive and living in a forest in Tuscany.
In 1996, a Spanish doctor named Carlos Sanchez Ortiz de Salazar disappeared from Seville, leaving behind a life overshadowed by depression. He looked for comfort in the unfamiliar and was eventually declared legally deceased in 2010. But life had other plans. 5 years later, mushroom pickers stumbled upon him living in the serene woods of Tuscany. Tuscany, Italy, for 18 long years. He had embraced silence, crafting a makeshift home and thriving in solitude. When found, Carlos revealed his identity with old documents and photos. But instead of returning to civilization, he vanished once more into the wilderness.
Carlos Sanchez Ortiz de Salazar, a doctor from Seville, dropped out in 1995 at the age of 26, suffering from depression. Two mushroom pickers discovered him by accident, but say he's now vanished again.
Lost adrift.
An incredible rescue caught on camera. A teenager lost at sea for 49 days.
For 19-year-old Aldi Novel Adilang, a routine fishing trip turned into a survival saga. Strong winds snapped his fishing raft's anchor, sending him drifting 1,200 miles from Indonesia to Guam. With no food or water, Aldi had to rely on sheer willpower, catching fish to eat and filtering seawater through his shirt to drink.
He survived, he said, by eating fish he'd caught and drinking seawater he filtered through his shirt.
For 49 days, countless ships passed him by, unaware of his silent cries for help. But finally, a massive tanker spotted him, and Aldi swam toward it, clinging to a life preserver. Against all odds, he made it, and proved that some battles at sea are won by courage, not by strength.
Adilang was to spend 6 months on board. He'd been working on that raft for 3 years, but says he's not going back ever.
Hiker for weeks.
Now to a miracle rescue out of California. A man stranded managed to survive on his own out in the wild for weeks without food, enduring frigid temperatures.
In 2022, a man got lost in the San Bernardino National Forest for 2 weeks. A couple enjoying their romantic camping trip heard his desperate cries for help and followed the sounds through rocky terrain. They found him in a creek bed, barely hanging on, with swollen feet and no food, just creek water for survival. Feeling hopeless, he had given up just days before their arrival. After they called 911, the rescue pilot swooped in to airlift him to safety. This incredible moment reminded everyone how important it is to stay safe while hiking. Many people get lost during the cooler months, but with some preparation, you can avoid ending up like this hiker. Hiker mom.
Learning new details tonight about a mother who was stranded in Utah's Zion National Park for nearly 2 weeks before she was finally rescued.
In 2020, Holly Cordier, a 38-year-old experienced hiker, disappeared in Utah's Zion National Park after failing to board a shuttle on October 6th. Her daughter refused to lose faith. So after nearly 2 weeks of intense searching with drones and K-9 units, a park visitor's tip led rescuers to Holly. She was found alive, a true testament to determination and hope. Holly had been visiting national parks after losing her job due to the pandemic, finding solace in nature.
She was very dehydrated and they found out she had a concussion and she couldn't move.
Vanishing act.
Mystery that got solved only to lead to another deeper mystery. Why would a seemingly happy husband and father disappear?
You can try to run, but you can't hide forever. And Richard Hoagland learned that the hard way. He seemed to have the perfect life in Indiana until he vanished without a trace in February 1993. His car was found abandoned, but all leads led to dead ends. Years passed, and he was declared legally deceased.
What did you love about him?
He was a lot of fun to be with.
Just when the family began to heal, a call from detectives revealed a shocking truth. Richard was alive, living under a false identity in Florida as Terry Szymanski. He'd stolen the identity of a deceased fisherman and built a new life, complete with a wife and child. But his past caught up with him when a family member of the real Terry started digging into genealogy.
Using that death certificate, he applies for a birth certificate. He submits that birth certificate to get a driver's license. Once he has that driver's license, he starts establishing his name is Terry Szymanski.
It's that easy.
This was some time ago.
Now facing charges for identity fraud, Richard's life is a stark reminder that secrets don't last forever.
Awaiting trial on charges including identity fraud.
So he's in a bad place.
Yes.
He can't stand to be confined in any one place. Now he can't go anywhere. It just kind of tickles me a little bit.
Amanda Eller.
Amanda Eller, a physical therapist who was lost on a hike in Maui, telling her story tonight for the first time since she was found after going missing for 17 days.
Amanda Eller, a yoga teacher and physical therapist, set out for a hike in the beautiful Hawaiian wilderness, but never made it back. When her boyfriend reported her missing, search teams quickly mobilized. Her car was discovered near Maui's Kahakapau Trail, but there was no sign of Amanda. After 17 grueling days, she was finally spotted by a search party and rescued by helicopter. Amanda reflected on her experience, saying that those were the toughest days of her life. In the wilderness, he had to rely on her instincts, surviving on wild plants, berries, and rainwater. Despite a fractured leg, she remained upbeat, thankful for the outpouring of support.
I'm so grateful to be alive. I wake up in the morning, I'm like, oh my God, I had a warm bed that I got to sleep in, and my body got to rest and to heal. My ankles are getting stronger, like, grateful for every breath.
Hidden identity.
Julian Hernandez discovered he'd been missing for 13 years, kidnapped from Alabama by his father, Bobby.
In August 2002, young Julian Hernandez was taken by his father, Bobby, who left only a brief note for Julian's mother. Instead of vanishing, they had settled in Cleveland, where Bobby created a new life for them. He obtained a Social Security card under the name Jonathan Mangina, and Julian grew up believing everything was normal, living with a stepmom and a little stepsister. He excelled in school and was set to start college. But in 2015, while applying for college, a school counselor uncovered Julian's true identity as a missing person. Authorities were notified, and Julian, now 19, was reunited with his mother. Despite everything, he forgave his dad.
I offer my apologies to my son and to his mother and her family.
Longest return.
Just when you think you've seen or heard everything, I then hear about your story. Your story, you solved one of the longest missing child cases in the United States history.
Let's have this incredible story. Steve Carter always knew he was adopted, but never looked into his birth story until a news story about a missing child sparked his curiosity. Steve found his own missing child case from 34 years ago. Turned out, he had unknowingly solved one of the longest missing child cases in U.S. history. At 6 months old, Steve had been abducted and left at a bus stop in Hawaii. After years of being raised by loving adoptive parents, Steve discovered he had multiple names, birth certificates, and family members searching for him all along. Though the mystery of his abduction remains unsolved, Steve's story is a beacon of hope for many.
It was a little surreal. You start reaching out to your friends and everybody's on, and I'm sending pictures and I'm saying, hey, who does this look like? And everybody's like, oh my God, that's you. And I was like, right?
Surprising return.
Well, sometimes timing is everything, Aaron and Shannon, and good news and a happy ending right now. The gentleman behind us you're looking at, that is Robert McDonough.
Sometimes life throws curveballs and you just gotta roll with them. Take Robert McDonough, for example. Back in May 2013, this elderly man from Lymington, Maine, went missing from his home. He had dementia, so everyone feared the worst. Search teams scoured the nearby woods all night, but came up empty. Then, the next morning, while a news crew was reporting live outside his house, who strolled up behind them? Robert himself, casually asking what all the fuss was about. Turned out he had wandered into the forest and spent the night there, safe and sound, and showed up when least expected. Sometimes folks find their way back just when you think they're gone for good.
This is, you identify him as Bob McDonough?
I think so. It's Bob McDonough. Yeah.
He looks a lot like a guy.
Watch yourself.
Memory restored.
A big break in a cold case from almost three decades ago. 21-year-old Edgar LaTulip disappeared in 1986.
Let's have this unexpected tale. Edgar LaTulip disappeared in 1986 at just 21 years old, vanishing from his rooming house in Kitchener. With a developmental delay, it was suspected he boarded a bus to Niagara Falls, but he remained missing for nearly 3 decades. But in January 2016, a breakthrough came when Edgar, living in St. Catharines, suddenly remembered his name. A head injury years ago had caused him to forget who he was. And after a DNA test, police confirmed his identity, closing a case that had baffled everyone. His family, though still processing the shock, was planning to reunite back then. Sometimes memories bring you home, even after years of wandering.
Mother Sylvia just called me back and says she's absolutely overwhelmed. She hasn't spoken with LaTulip yet.
Found again. Time may pass, but hope never fades. And this case is the ultimate proof of that. Alex Batty was only 11 when he vanished during a 2017 vacation in Spain. 6 years later, in 2023, he was found safe in France. Greater Manchester Police confirmed his return to the UK, marking the end of a long, heartbreaking search.
It gives me great pleasure to say Alex now made his safe return back to the UK after 6 years.
Alex had been taken to a spiritual commune in Spain, but made the brave decision to leave. While walking along a road in France, he identified himself to a driver who offered him a ride. Though the details surrounding his disappearance remain unclear, what matters most is that Alex was back.
We are yet to fully establish the circumstances surrounding his disappearance. He may now be 6 years older than when he went missing, but he is still a young person.
Lost and found.
Amazing story, new at 11. A Santa Cruz County man is back tonight after spending 10 days in the mountain. He went for a hike, but says he got lost.
A short hike can sometimes turn into a real-life survival story. That's exactly what happened to Lucas McClish. On the 10th of June, 2024, he set out for a quick 3-hour hike from Boulder Creek, but got lost in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Days passed, and he missed Father's Day dinner. By June 16th, Lucas was declared missing, triggering a massive search. Armed with only a flashlight and a multi-tool, Lucas survived for 10 days, drinking water from streams. Finally, on June 20th, searchers found him in a remote canyon at Big Basin State Park. Lucas and his family were beyond relieved and thankful for all the help. Sometimes being lost just brings you closer to what matters most.
I would just make sure that I drank at least a gallon of water every day. It was just really humbling and, it was an awesome experience.
Wilderness miracle. Sometimes hope is all you need to keep going. Joshua McClatchy found that out the hard way. In 2019, this Fort Worth hiker got lost while exploring the Buckeye Trail in Arkansas, spending nearly a week wandering in the wilderness. His family never gave up, and their prayers were answered when cell phone data led rescuers straight to him. On the day he was found, Joshua's sister reunited with him after 7 agonizing days. He spent his 38th birthday alone in the wild, but now he was back, thankful for the search teams and everyone who helped bring him home.
Joshua McClatchy's family never gave up hope that he'd be found, and those prayers were answered. Tonight he is recovering in the hospital.
Survival spirit.
Smoke from California wildfires hampered the east for a hiker who'd been missing in the Sierra National Forest for 9 days.
Sometimes the toughest battles are fought in silence. Just ask Miyuki Harwood. In 2015, the 62-year-old hiker disappeared in the rugged Sierra National Forest after getting separated from her group. With a broken leg and almost no supplies, she managed to crawl to a creek, drinking from it to survive. For 9 days, smoke from California's wildfires complicated search efforts, but Miyuki didn't give up. Early one morning, searchers finally heard her faint whistle. She was found, alive and conscious, and flown to a hospital 100 miles away. Her family's joy was overwhelming, and now Miyuki's only wish was for some much-needed rest.
She was conscious, she was talking. She's very, very grateful that she was found.
Hike surprise. Winds sometimes can come your way when you least expect them. That's what happened to 73-year-old Gab Song during a hike on Mount Pinos in California. A sudden blizzard rolled in, and Song, who was supposed to be home by evening, disappeared. When his phone went to voicemail at midnight, his family got worried and called the police. Search teams scoured the area with four-wheelers and helicopters, but the surprise ending came when a private citizen found Song safe at a home in Lockwood Valley.
Song has been located safe, in good condition. He was located in the Lockwood Valley area by a private citizen.
No one's sure how he got there, but the important thing was he made it back.
I just know that the snowstorm was just such a random occurrence. I feel like he was not prepared for, because we thought he was going to be home early evening.
Days under the boat.
A man who survived nearly 3 days underneath a capsized boat in the Atlantic.
Survival is just about finding the smallest glimmer of hope. And Harrison O'Keen, the cook aboard a Chevron oil boat, found his in the most unlikely place, in a tiny air pocket under his capsized boat. After it flipped in rough seas off Nigeria, Harrison spent nearly 3 days in complete darkness, surrounded by the Atlantic's chilling waters, while 11 of his colleagues tragically met their fate. With no food or water, all he could do was listen to the sounds of the ocean. Finally, divers arrived, expecting to recover bodies, but were shocked to find him alive. Against all odds, Harrison's miracle came, and he was lifted to safety.
I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't just seen it. A man told his rescuers that he was the cook on that boat. Interestingly, his rescuers, those rescue divers, do this for a living, said that for some reason, cooks always find a way to survive.
Ocean Rescue.
Thank God for it being a nice day so we can save you guys here.
When fate throws you overboard, you just have to hope for a lifeline. That's what happened to three fishermen near Palm Beach, Florida. Their small, 5-meter boat capsized during what should have been a routine fishing trip, leaving them stranded in the Atlantic with no way to save themselves. Just when things seemed bleak, fate sent a much larger fishing boat their way. Two fishermen, who had rented the bigger boat for their own trip, spotted the stranded men and rushed to help. Thanks to that stroke of luck, all three were rescued.
Listen, they're gonna come get your boat. You shouldn't go under there. You could get trapped under there.
Lost at sea.
Hi, sir. You speak English? Yeah. How are you doing?
For 54-year-old Tim Shattuck and his dog, Bella, what started as an adventure trip from Mexico's Baja Peninsula to French Polynesia turned into a 3-month fight for survival. Bad weather knocked out their electricity just weeks into their voyage, leaving them stranded in the Pacific. Tim relied on his fishing skills when their supplies ran out, catching raw fish to survive. Their luck finally changed when a tuna fishing crew spotted them and came to the rescue. After being rescued, Tim was very grateful and was looking forward to returning to Australia and hugging his family.
I departed Mexico on, where from Mexico? La Paz?
Tracked Rescue.
Swimmers, many of them kids, who recorded their own rescue at sea, their boat sinking, and ABC's Nick Watt on what they had that saved them. It was the only way this helicopter came to get them.
Preparation can save your skin. And for this group of swimmers, it definitely did. Four adults and four kids found themselves stranded 12 miles off Hawaii when their 21-foot boat started sinking fast. In a quick move, they jumped into kayaks and lashed them together, wading helplessly in shark-infested waters. But the real lifesaver, a GPS tracking device they brought along.
It takes the search out of search and rescue. If it goes off, it takes us right to their position.
This tiny gadget sent their exact location to rescuers, cutting out the guesswork. After 2 hours of waiting, a helicopter arrived and the group was safely rescued. That tracker, just worth a few dollars, turned a potential tragedy into a happy reunion.
We're gonna live!
It was like such a good sight to see. Like, we were waiting for about 2 hours, and when we saw it, we were just so stoked.
Gone for years.
Hola. Hello.
You know what real fear is? It's like being stranded alone in the middle of the ocean. And that's exactly what happened in 2020 when two Colombian fishermen discovered what looked like a floating log, but it turned out to be 46-year-old Angelica Gaitan, who had been missing for 2 years, suffering from hypothermia but alive. Angelica shared her heart-wrenching story of escaping a 20-year abusive marriage and jumping into the sea, hoping to end her pain. Amazingly, she survived 8 hours in the water before being found. Although her daughters questioned parts of her story, Angelica sees her rescue as a second chance at life, proving that even in the darkest moments, hope can float. Air pocket. Where there's space, there's life. That was the reality for Simal, a chef trapped beneath a capsized fishing boat off Istanbul's coast. The boat was carrying 13 crew members, and it flipped unexpectedly, leaving Simal stuck in a small air pocket near the engine room. While he anxiously waited for 4 long hours, others on board met their fates. But Turkish divers were able to save Simal standing in the submerged vessel. They handed him a diving mask and safely guided him to the surface. Simal's relief was immense. Thankful for the rescue, he expressed his deep sorrow, knowing he had narrowly escaped the same fate. Lucky waves. While on a Thanksgiving cruise in 2022, a 28-year-old was hanging out with 18 family members when he suddenly fell overboard without the notice of anyone else. When they found he was missing, it caused panic among his loved ones. He managed to stay afloat in the Gulf of Mexico for almost 20 hours, fighting exhaustion and fear. At one point, he had a scary encounter with what he thought was a shark, but then he saw the lights of a tanker ship. With all his strength, he swam towards it. Finally, the Coast Guard spotted him and made a miraculous rescue. Hidden truths. Back in 1984, Petra Pashitka was set to celebrate her brother's birthday, but she never showed up. It wasn't until 1989 that a suspected criminal confessed to being involved in her disappearance, and many believed she was gone for good. Fast forward to 2015, when police were called to a burglary in Dusseldorf. The victim, calling herself Mrs. Schneider, revealed an astonishing truth. She was Petra Pashitka, alive and well after over 30 years of living under a false identity. When found, Petra refused to explain her disappearance and made it clear she didn't want to reunite with her family. Despite her long absence, she insisted family troubles weren't the reason for her sudden exit. Unexpected reunion. Harold Wayne Level was believed to be a victim of the notorious John Wayne Gacy back in the late 70s, with many convinced he'd been taken down. But in the early 2010s, police were digging into Gacy's unknown victims when they stumbled upon a shocking twist. Harold was alive and living in South Florida. Harold had no clue he was presumed deceased, nor did he realize he was once connected to Gacy, having worked for him before vanishing. After fleeing Chicago due to family troubles, he kept his distance for over 30 years. The moral of the story? You never know how things will turn out until the very end. Gone for decades. In 1997, a little boy playing outside his home in China was snatched away at just 2 years old. For over 20 years, his parents' hearts were heavy with sorrow. They never gave up hope, especially his dad, who embarked on a relentless journey across China. Riding his motorcycle, he distributed flyers and followed leads, burning through 10 bikes and all their savings. Finally, in 2021, fate smiled upon them. The police found a man matching their son's description. A DNA test confirmed their worst fears had turned into a dream. He was alive. The 26-year-old son was joyfully reunited with his parents. 40 years of escape. Back in 1970, Lula Hood vanished from Illinois, leaving her family in the dark. For years, they believed she had met a tragic end after her supposed remains were discovered in a Florida brickyard in 1996. But as technology advanced, the truth unfolded in 2009, when DNA testing revealed that the remains weren't hers. This shocking news reopened the case, sending investigators on a new quest. They discovered that Lula had been living quietly in Florida for the past 40 years. Apparently, after a family spat, she packed her bags and embraced a new life far away, savoring her anonymity. It's a wild twist in a story that reminds us that sometimes people just want to escape.
It was her, but at that time they couldn't do DNA because it wasn't that advanced yet.
Gone for 7 years. Timothy Carney vanished in September 2004, leaving behind an empty car near Newark and a lot of unanswered questions. His last call to his employer mentioned he'd be late to work, but that was the last anyone heard from him for 7 long years. His family searched for answers, holding on to hope. Finally, in 2011, Timothy was found safe, but details about his disappearance remained scarce. His family believed he may have been influenced by a religious group called Gospel Outreach, which led him to sever ties with his loved ones. But what's the truth? It was only known to Timothy. Open discussion.
You might remember Dr. Joe DeTore from when he joined us back in April. This is him discussing his mission to live underwater for 100 days.
Joseph DeTore, also known as a Dr. Deep Sea, set a new world record by living underwater for 74 days at Jules' Undersea Lodge in Key Largo, Florida. DeTore, a university professor, decided to conduct experiments to study how long-term exposure to underwater pressure affects the human body.
What was it like being underwater for 100 days, and how does it feel to break this record?
For me, it was never about the record. It was more about the actual study that we were doing.
Although it was a risky move, and people assumed he would not survive. But guess what? Not only did he survive, but the study showed an increase in stem cells and overall improved health. It was like he was aging in reverse compared to everyone else his age.
My preliminary results indicate that I had a decrease in cholesterol by 73 points. I also had every single inflammatory marker in my body decrease by about half, give or take.
Though DeTore enjoyed his time beneath the waves, there was one thing he truly missed. The sun.
So we're going to brief this at the World Extreme Medicine Conference in November, and then from there we hope that somebody will pick it up and expand on the study of living in an isolated, confined, extreme environment over the next, you know, whatever it takes to get us from here to Mars.
Thank you very much for watching the video. Do like it and share it with your friends. Subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to not miss any of the upcoming amazing videos. Thank you once again.